Pity Beats here from Pop Turner, speaking to Nolan Gould about Miranda's victim in theaters, select theaters, and on demand October 6th. Welcome to the show, man. Thanks so much for being here.
Yeah, thanks for having me. Glad to be here.
There's a lot to play with this movie. It's based on true events. You're going back in time aesthetically wise for this. You know what I mean? It's a thriller. It's very important in terms of, you know, these are events that I feel like we really need to know about. What kind of stands out to you the most when you're kind of reading the script and you sign on to a project like this?
Yeah, I think, look, there's a ton that stood out to me. You know, this movie has a ton going for it. Yeah. Like, I'll be honest, like, I'm not typically a heavy drama or, like courtroom, like, legal proceedings or, you know, period piece kind of guy. But upon, like, this was, like, a page turner for me. Yeah. And I read it in one night. You know, so if you ever watch a movie or a show and you hear read them their Miranda rights, we've all heard that 100 times, had no clue what it meant. And so I got this letter from the director, Michelle. She was like, hey, I would really love for you to be a part of this project. Read this script. I started reading. And so this is the first time this story tells the formation of the Miranda rights, but also tells it from the perspective of Patricia Weir, who is the victim of Ernesto Miranda. Who the name Miranda rights come from. And so it both informs you about this crazy legal proceeding and this event, this thing that we needed to have happen, which was the formation of the Miranda rights, but the terrible way in which that it happened, and also bringing forth and bringing to light Patricia Weir's story after decades of being untold. I think it's really important. I think it's fascinating. I think for, you know, fans of the legal system or, you know, people who are survivors of sexual assault or people who, there's so much here for different groups of people. Yeah. And I think it's an important story and I hope that people get a chance to see it.
I feel like when you read a script for this, I mean, you kind of what you said, about being a page turner. I feel like, do you read the whole thing and then kind of think about this is packed, there's a lot here? Because I feel like different scripts have those different kind of reactions, right? But what is your first kind of reaction when you're realizing, you said, all these elements are kind of thrown in one movie specifically?
Yeah. Well, typically scripts are madness. I don't, if anybody out there has ever read a script, what you read is often way different than what is actually shown, because you have visualized, but the director and the writer and these actors are all going to do and how it's going to look, and maybe a little confused here and blah blah blah. And I'm not the fastest reader. I don't have great reading comprehension, and so typically I'll come in, I'll read 20 pages, come back in another day, read another 20 pages, start to kind of build this thing in my mind. And this script was so well written that I literally started reading it, I think at late in the night, while I was shooting another project, sort of midnight. And I just kept going. And it was all so clear. And so many things stood out to me where I was oh, whoa, there's a lot here. And that's one of the cool things is doing these screenings and going to, we've been traveling all across the country, and I think they've even taken it abroad, is seeing the different reactions that people have while we're doing the Q&As.
Yeah.
And the really, I guess the dialogue that happens afterwards of where this movie gets people talking. Mm. And I feel your only hope as an actor is you get to be a part of stories that make people think, and then they leave the movie theater and they're that thing that you have when you leave the movie theater with your friends and you just can't stop talking about it.
Absolutely. And I feel that's the goal, right? That's the goal. I feel we want to see those projects now, right? What you said,
not just leaving the theater wow, I really love that, that was, this part was good, but also leaving being yo, what did you think of that? Or mm-hmm. Hey man, that was really dark, but also really important. And in a weird way, this terrible event led to this thing that is really important and integral part of our society and helps us all get justice. And I don't know. It's, you got to see it. It's, I truly stand behind this this film. I've done some films where like I don't talk about them as much, don't do that much press. This one I'm like, no, I'm serious. But like I am telling people like go and see this film because like when I read it, like I knew I had to be a part of it.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Does the mindset change depending on the genre of the project, whether it's like a comedy or a thriller or a drama, or is it all storytelling to you? Like preparation wise? Yeah.
It's something I'm still like figuring out. Like in a weird way, I've been doing this 20 years now, and I'm still very young in my process of
20 years.
Old. Yeah. I started when I was 5 years old. I'm about to be 25. Yeah. But I'm still like, I think, you know, acting is a constant process of growing and learning. And, you know, I did Modern Family for 11 years and very different world than what this lives in. But at the same time, you are just telling stories. They're meant to elicit different things. Modern Family was a really great blend of like, yeah, we're trying to entertain you and maybe we're going to like Trojan horse you with some feelings.
But it kind of was pretty deep too. There was some deep stuff
like,
in Modern Family.
Man, when I watched that finale, like I sobbed. Like, yeah. You know, for like a whole room of people. For the multiple reasons, because my, you know, in one way, a chapter of my life was ending, but so was Modern Family. And it was just sad. And like, this is a very different world. And yeah. I had to learn, like, kind of on the go, like, where these characters live. And, but, you know, a lot of what it is just finding the common thread of humanity. I know that sounds really, like, generic, maybe, like, I've heard that before, but it is true. Like, with Luke on Dumpy and Modern Family, I was like, okay, this is a real human being. He lives in this kind of, like, big world where everything is big and over the top, and Miranda's victim is like this character James is a real person, and I have to like get in his head and figure out like where can we empathize with his actions and why he does the things that he does. You're telling stories, but they're for different reasons, and at the same time you're just trying to find out like at the end of the day we're all human, what makes us do the things that we do.
Yeah, and the cast is pretty big for Miranda's victim. You didn't get a chance to work with like everyone, but like what was that like, the people that you got to see, like from a learning experience perspective, like what was that like for you?
I mean, that was one of the major reasons I signed on to be a part of this project as well. Because reading through the cast list, Abigail Breslin, Luke Wilson, Ryan Phillippe, Donald Sutherland, like it just keeps going and going. You're like, how is that? What this is like. You know, the bench goes deep on this, and I was like, just to be even included in this list was an honor. And I mainly got to work with Abigail and Enrique Murciano, and you know, I had been so used to working with the same people for like 11 years that getting to like settle in with them and watch their process, and like seriously, like these are some, like Abigail's been doing it just as long if not longer than me. And like seeing like the grace that she brought to this role, and you know, she had a very difficult role playing Patricia Weir, and like had to go through a lot, and just like, I don't know, getting to act with her was really special. I'll tell you one thing that was difficult though, and I always laugh about this, is that it takes place in the 1950s, and so we're all like wearing like wool uniforms. Working at this movie theater. We're in New Jersey in the summer. It's so hot. It's like 90 degrees and humid at night. And we're doing this scene inside a bus from the 1950s with no AC. Mm-hmm. And we're trying to have like a beautiful moment, like between us, like a little spark. It's could this be love moment? And I watched like a bead of sweat drip down Abigail Breslin's head into her like eye. And she didn't blink. I was like, I just watched that happen. You like, do you need a second? Like, we're like, it's hot in here. We're dying. But like, you could not break her. Everyone was just so professional. And I was just like, I don't know. I'm kind of a nerd and a fan of a lot of them. And so I really,
Do you like to talk and kind of converse about strategies and plans with directors and actors when you're on set, or do you kind of just kind of do your own thing? Like, are there conversations that happen before takes?
I have a strict "don't look at me" policy when it. I'm totally kidding.
I feel like maybe you're not lying about that. Like, I feel like people are in the zone sometimes.
You know, some people do. I think
that was a good one.
You know, whatever. Somebody's gonna like look at that and be like, Nolan Gould is rude on set. No, I think, you know, that what you're talking about right there is kind of the joy of creation and the joy of Yep. Acting and storytelling is like that's the thing. And, you know, everyone has their own way of doing it. Some people are like, yeah, let's plan it out ahead of time. Some people, like, you know, working with Michelle Danner, she is an actor and an acting coach as well as a director. And so she knows how to direct actors. And like, that was like a ton of like, let's not talk about it. Let's just bring out like the best parts of you. Like, let's breathe and relax. And like, you're here, you have the time, explore, do what you want to do. And I really appreciated that. And then there's other actors who are like, let's see what happens in the moment.
Yeah.
And, you know, Enrique Murciano, who plays one of the detectives, is a great example of that. Is just like, sometimes we were just like, he's like, let's just improv this whole scene and like see where it goes. And then you just get on a thread that you like and you follow it. And then something new gets created. And so everyone kind of has their own way of doing it.
And 100%. And the last question before we wrap up, because mindsets always interest me from like kind of the actor perspective. You said about like the joy of creation and everything. I always love the behind the scenes. That's like one of my favorite. These are my favorite interviews because I love talking about that stuff. When you wrap the film, like your stuff at least, like you're done with the film, right?
Yeah.
I guess I feel like it depends on the project, but what is kind of that next step mindset? Like, do you need to take a break? Are you like, all right, let's go to the next project? Like, what are you feeling after you wrap projects?
Yeah, it's great question, because there's this kind of inherent human need to like, okay, like that's done. Now I'm looking at my calendar and it's empty and I've got like panic mode of like, I got to do something. But then I think that kind of misses out on like, almost like, I don't even want to say like the word mourning feels like bad, but like, I guess like when Modern Family ended, I was like, obviously I was like, I need a minute. This is like,
that was a big part of your life. I know. That was like, how many years were you on that show?
It was 11. It was between 10 to 21.
It was a decade of your life.
Yeah. And so that was very much like, let's not rush anything. Luckily and unluckily, it ended in early 2020, and then a little thing called pandemic happened, and so like you definitely had some time to reflect on it. But
yeah,
with Miranda's Victim, it was like I also didn't want to rush to do anything and hop on anything else, because I like I needed a second to think about this like incredible group of people that I got to be a part of and like be proud of it. And then you take a second, you're like, okay, what did I learn from that? Do I want to, from there, hop back into something that's a little more like comedic? Or do you like, oh, there was a lot to be learned and enjoyed here. Let's kind of go down this hole a little bit further. And I think I'm still kind of in it, like figuring out, you know, like what is that? What's that next thing? And like, where do you want to go? And what stories do you want to tell? Because it was great telling in a meaningful, important story that I've gotten to go to Q&As and see like people's reactions to survivors' reactions and like what it means to them. You're like, this is obviously there's weight here. And there's like, there's not like bad pressure, but you have this thing that's important. And do you want to continue to kind of tell those stories? And I think for me, it is like, I am attracted to that.
Yeah, absolutely. And no, really important film. I can't wait for people to see Miranda's Victim in select theaters and on demand October 6th. Nolan, so great chatting with you, man. Thanks so much for your time.
Great to chat with you. Please go watch the movie and enjoy it. We worked really hard on it.
And Instagram is the best way for people to keep up date with your stuff, right? They just put Nolan Gould in Instagram.
At Nolan Gould, come follow along in the journeys.
Awesome. Well, this has been PopTurn at youtube.com/PopTurn for previous episodes. Until next time, this is Nolan Gould and PD Beats signing off.
Thank you for tuning in to PopTurnative. Make sure to check out our past episodes of PopTurnative on YouTube.
This has been an Autograph Communications production.